Hi, welcome to Airtech Solutions. Let's see one more video on interfacing with microcontrollers. So most of you aware of how to work with these different peripherals with microcontrollers. So before starting anything connection with microcontroller, so you should be aware of VI characteristics of individual devices. This is the most important thing before proceeding any interfacing with microcontroller and peripherals. First you have to clear idea on voltage and current characteristics. So it may be microcontroller and LCD, it may be microcontroller and motors, or whatever the device you are trying to interface. So first know their VA characteristics. Even you are doing any experiment, so in colleges or labs or any application, first of all engineer has to know the complete characteristics. So these individual devices, then only you can prepare your own interfacing circuit. So as interfacing circuit, you may use diodes, resistors, capacitors, driver ICs, switching components like transistors, relays, MOSFETs, IGBTs, triacs, SCRs. There are many more interfacing components you can use for your applications. So why we are using specific component here, that will give you clear idea on this VA characteristics. So now I am proceeding with microcontroller interfacing with peripherals. So this is your basic reset circuit you should understand. So why you need these external components for microcontroller, and using by connecting these mandatory components with the microcontroller, you can proceed for interfacings. So here 9th pin required one external RC combination to provide time constant to the microcontroller. So whenever you are operating reset button, so this is your reset button, so it provides time constant for us based on discharging cycle of capacitor. And here I am connecting external crystal oscillator across 18 and 19. So this generates clock cycles, and these clock cycles are used for program execution, so that you can discuss on mission cycle. Mission cycle means the time taken to execute an instruction is called mission cycle. And these two capacitors will filter the noise generated from this oscillator. And this 31 pin also required VCC connection, so that you are not looking for external access because it is active low. By giving VCC connection, you are disabling your external access. And now I am proceeding with basic LED interfacing with microcontroller. So before interfacing your LED with microcontroller, first know their individual characteristics. So anyway, this is a symbol for your basic LED which contains anode and cathode leads. And you are looking to turn on your LED, it starts from 1.8 volt DC supply and as current which requires 5 to 10 milliamps. And this is the outview of your LEDs, and internally this is your anode and cathode lead. And measuring your LEDs with small and big leads, whereas big lead indicates that it is a positive side, which means anode, and the small lead indicates that it is a cathode. Otherwise there is a square representation of cathode side, that also you can notice that this is your cathode and anode from the LED. And connecting your LED with microcontroller, you need some resistance based on voltage and current characteristics of IO pin. So most of you are aware of microcontroller works with two standard logics, logic 1 and logic 0. So logic 1 means it provides 5 volts and current rating is 10 milliamps approximately. Based on your source voltage, you have to connect your resistance after or before. So if you are connecting resistance before load, then it is treated as pull-up resistor. And if you are connecting resistance after load, it is treated as pull down resistor. So it depends on the characteristics of your load and source, you have to use your resistance before or after. So if source voltage is more than load requirement, then you need to add resistor before. If source voltage is similar to your load, then you need to add resistance after. So this is my simple interfacing circuit with microcontroller and LED, and also assembly language program. So this is your basic LED interfacing circuit with microcontroller. So let's see this. I am just connecting across resistance with LED across P2.0 pin. And see the program, clear P2.0 and delay, set bit P2.0 and A call delay. So why you need to add delay in between set and clear? So as a logic, clear means off and set means on. But so LED has some response time. So even if you are giving supply, it doesn't comes to on directly. If you're giving logic 0, it doesn't off directly. So you need to apply some delay between high and low, so that you can watch the response from LED. So here, as a delay, what I'm writing? Loop, self loop concept with registers. So I'm giving some unnecessary task to the microcontroller, giving some value to register, maximum value 255. Otherwise, you can give FFH in hexadecimal. So first, decrementing R2 value and dollar, which means self loop. So I am decrementing R2 value up to 0 here with this instruction, and then again I am decrementing R1 value by 1, again reassigning R2 value with 255, so that this loop executes 255 into 255 into 2 mission cycles. So it will generate time in milliseconds at least, and then RET, which means return from delay program to main program. So now I will compile the same source code in Keil Microvision IDE, and I'll show you output with Proteus simulation. So how to start writing program with Keil Microvision? So go project tab and choose the option new Microvision project. And now you can go with your specific drive. So I'm writing LED interfacing. This is my project name. So after choosing your target drive, give your project name and click on save. Now this is the window for choosing your microcontroller. So Keil Microvision IDE supports for all different manufacturers. You can choose one specific manufacturer from this list. Choose Atmel and click on plus mark. It will show the list of devices from this manufacturer. From this list, choose AT89C51 and click on OK. And this is your startup code warning, click on no. So up to now you selected your target device. Now open editor window to write the program. To write your program, go file tab and use option new. This is the text editor, here you can type your program. So now what is my program? Clear P2.0 and A call delay. And set bit P2.0 and A call delay, and I am repeating this process again. So this is a simple logic to see the response from LED on and off. So now what about delay program here? So I'm giving some random values to registers. And first I'm decrementing one register value up to 0. By using this DJNZR3, and the next instruction I am decrementing R2 value by 1, and I am going back with the label L1. So this label I am giving it R3 value, so that here these two lines will execute 255 times again. So return and end. This is the simple assembly language program. Now, after writing program in text editor, go file tab and choose option save. So give the program name as LED interfacing, but program name should save with .asm extension. because this is assembly language program. So if your font is not clear, then go with standard format. Now, so whatever the program you written, first just select your target with respect to which target you are trying to compile this program. Select source group 1 and right click it, add the file, which is by default it will show you C source files. Now you need to select a sim source file, click on add and close. Now to compile this program, go project tab and choose option build target. If any errors and warnings present in this program, it will show you. Now to execute this program with hardware, you need to create .hex file. Further, select target 1 and choose the option options for target 1 and give the oscillator frequency as per your hardware. Highlight this use on chip ROM option and click on output tab and highlight this create X file option, click on OK. And again go with project tab and choose option build target. Now minimize your programming window and open your hardware tool, which is Proteus simulation tool. This is one popular simulation tool. You can check your all hardware results with the help of software. Now select your microcontroller by clicking on P symbol and double click on device, it will come into the list. And remove your component name and type it your next component, which is red LED. Place your controller on design and select your component LED. So I am connecting anode end with IO pin and cathode end with ground. So ground connection I will get it in terminals mode. Select your ground and connect it. Now the created hex file you need to link with this simulation tool by double click on controller. It will ask program file option. Click on this program file, go with the path where your hex file is present in the computer. So this is my hex file LED interfacing. Select your file and mention the frequency, how much you are taking from the hardware. And use this play button to run your simulation. Now you can watch the output, which is on and off with the LED. So this is how you can check your hardware results by writing program in Keil Microvision and checking your outputs with Proteus simulation tool. So for more videos, please subscribe our channel and give your valuable feedback as comment and like and share. And we are doing training on different modules, C data structures with Linux and Python and Linux, IoT, robotics and Raspberry Pi with all different microcontrollers. We are working on 5 different controllers, 8051 families, PIC, NodeMCU and Raspberry Pi and BeagleBone. We are offering even internships, paid internships for the engineering students. So to reach our office, please follow this address: Rajamma Towers, Jainagar, Bhagyanagar Colony, near KPHB Metro Station, Kukatpalli, Hyderabad. If any query, please write an email us, ysnanda@eritechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.